Turning Hulk Hogan, the Mama Lukes, the Harlem Heat situation, that's all still to come on Saturday. Welcome. Well, that's about a day late and a dollar short right there, Brain, if you don't mind. We've got 2 minutes for commercial timeout. Can you please try to make it back in time?
Well, if they had clocks here that work and if they had announcing equipment that worked, they didn't buy them at discount stores, maybe my equipment would work.
All right, I'll tell you what. Write that complaint down and send it to Brad, the sound guy. He'll get right on it. The Power Company making their way to the ring. Attention, fans in Sacramento, California. Tickets still available for Nitro. 1 week from Monday night, February 21st at the Arco Arena. And tickets available now for Nitro at the Target Center in Minneapolis. We will be in the Twin Cities on February 28th for Nitro. And we invade North Kakalaki, Chapel Hill, North Carolina, at the Smith Center on March 6th. Tickets still available for Sacramento, Minneapolis, and Chapel Hill. You just can't miss Nitro.
You know, you're talking about Nitro. What about this coming Monday night from Uniondale, Long Island? Hulk Hogan returns to the New York City area, and his match will be against Ric Flair, both former world champions. You know what the history is like with those two. But Hogan returning to New York City, Long Island, it's going to be great.
As Mark Jindrak and Elix Skipper make their way into the ring here on the Superstation.
Whoa, whoa, who?
Mark Jindrak and Elix Skipper, two graduates. That's right, you haven't been on the Saturday Night Show. Power Plant graduates facing the Power Company.
Which is Skippy?
Well, neither one of them are Skippy, actually. That's Elix Skipper in the ring, being hammered by one half of the Power Company.
Why can't we just call him Skippy?
You tell him that.
He might like the name.
It's an
action-packed name.
Skippy?
Skippy.
Well, Pete's saying.
No, Pete's the other guy, isn't he?
No, it's Mark. Power Company.
Whoa.
Oh! Miscommunication by the Power Company. Skipper, wow!
Just think, when they look at each other and start arguing with each other, it's like they're talking to themselves.
That's not an interesting conversation, actually. Crossbody. Lateral press. No, Willie Skipper got the two count. Let's go back to what you were talking about Monday night from Uniondale, Long Island, Nitro at the Nassau Coliseum. Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair, Brain, you were there in the 1980s. You know exactly what Hulkamania did for this sport. We all know what Ric Flair has meant to professional wrestling. They have done battle in the past. Both men have scored pinfall victories over the other. But this is about ego. No titles on the line. Ric Flair furious that Hulk Hogan was named the best wrestler of the last 100 years by WCW Magazine. Oh, Skipper got a two count. Flair thought he should have been number one. He was number two. He's going to take it out of Hogan's hide Monday night.
And how long has it been since Hogan has wrestled in the New York City area? Quite some time.
Long time. Mark Jindrak on top. Quick drop kick, and he got a two count on one half of the Power Company. Let me tell you a story about Mark Jindrak, Brain.
What's his name, Mark Dirtbat?
Yes, Mark Dirtbag. How about Mark Jindrak?
Jindrak.
Jindrak.
Jinny and Skippy. We'll keep it easy.
Oh, boy. Skipper with a two count on one half of the Power Company. Jindrak suspended from collegiate basketball for aggressive play. Can you imagine someone losing his ride in college as a basketball player? And Jindrak's a big guy, a terrific athlete. He got hammered by the NCAA for aggressive play. He was too rough on the court.
But what you don't know is that he went to an all-girls college.
You're kidding me.
No.
Now, wait a minute.
The basket's almost 4 feet.
Well, no wonder he was such a superstar. I want to check that out.
He could be a little aggressive.
Mark Jindrak trying his hand at pro wrestling after the basketball gig didn't go anywhere because he couldn't quit throwing punches on the hardwood. Power Company. Double team maneuver on Skipper. Double sledge into the spot of the back. Down goes the youngster. Coming up in our next segment, we will take an in-depth look at the situation. Hang on, Power Company on top. Lateral press. Elix Skipper out at two. An in-depth look at what's going on inside the brand new Harlem Heat and their situation with Booker.
Well, there's a lot of jealousy there. You know, I don't think Stevie Ray likes the idea that, Booker likes the idea of Stevie Ray hanging around with Mr. Big T.
I don't want to hang around Big T. That guy's huge. You see that guy in catering? It's like four plates. like he's serving a meal for 10 people, and it's just his stuff. Guy's massive. Power Company putting a boot right into the throat of Felix Skipper, and the Power Company aptly named duo. Look at the arm. Look at the guns on these two. Skipper into the ropes. Power Company. Double shot right in the breadbasket. Double sledge into the shoulder. Both men putting the boots to Felix Skipper. Referee Mark Johnson needs to step in there and maintain some control.
Come on, Skippy.
Skipper. Felix Skipper. Powerbomb attempt. Up top. Oh, we got a double power bomb. Wow, clothesline into a power bomb from the Power Company. Lateral press. Mark Jindrak breaks it up. That may have been a three count on the way. I'm surprised to see Jindrak getting along so well with his partner. Obviously, he does not play well with others.
Well, that's just girls basketball. He did very well here at WCW.
I don't know about that girls' school thing, Crane. Are you sure?
That's what Tanae told me.
I believe it then.
The human shredder.
Power Company, another bit of miscommunication. Hang on a second.
Come on, Skipper, get the Gilligan, make the tag.
There's the tag to Mark Jindrak. Oh, and talk about aggressive play. He is doing a number on the Power Company. What a lariat.
Hello.
Oh, cut it off. Left hand from the southpaw. Power Company to the ropes. Another lariat. Good.
And he was lucky there. He's got to learn not to turn his back in that ring. Stay focused on whatever you're in the ring with, no matter how many men are in there or who they are. Never, never turn your back.
Jindrak reintroducing the Power Company. He did it again, and he blocked it. Shoots him into, one Power Company into the other, and oh, please. I don't have to tell you how bad that hurts. Skipper on top of the ring. Touch, drop kick. Level the Power Company. Springboard lariat from Jindrak.
Skipper. Skippy did it. Skippy did it.
Skipper. Felix Skipper and Mark Jindrak are your winners. What a victory from the youngsters from the power plant. Keep your eye on both of those two athletes. Something special brewing right there. And talk about something special. How about Super Brawl 2000? 1 week from tomorrow night, Snickers presents Super Brawl for World Championship Wrestling in a death match. The Nation Boy Ric Flair and the hardcore legend Terry Funk will do battle at Super Brawl
16.
It seems like the news has never come more fast or furious than it has in the last few weeks in World Championship Wrestling. There is only one place to get the complete story. That's the WCW hotline, Tony.
They say that Gene Okerlund has made a very handsome living off of gossip and dirt. We know it to be true. Gene Okerlund is the man, and I know this week he has some information that we cannot tell you here on the program. It's worth the call.
I tell you what, somebody better start a hotline selling scandals and gossip about Gene Okerlund. Boy, talk about money in the bank.
That's right.
Don't miss Mike Tenay on Monday with a complete weekend recap and a preview of Nitro. Mark Madden, Bob Ryder, they're all there. Pick up the phone and dial 1-900-909-9900. It's the WCW hotline.
Fans, want to reiterate, if you want to see the action of WCW Saturday night as we take these great matches, this coming Wednesday, we're going to be at the campus of the University of Massachusetts in Amherst, the Mullen Center. That's the former basketball home of College of Dr. J. And we're going to be taping WCW Saturday night this Wednesday, Scott Hudson.
Wonder if he'll be there.
I doubt it.
Dadgummit.
Now, he may be with us, I guess, later in the year. We're going to have Thunder in Orlando. At the Orlando Arena, he may show up there.
Is that where he lives? He stays in Orlando these days?
Yeah, that's where he lives.
Be super to see Dr. J if he shows up at Thunder. Speaking of Dr. J and basketball, take a look at Mark Jindrak. Still can't get over his lifetime ban by the NCAA. Rough play on the court. Bought him a lifetime ban. But he does have great abs.
We call it Mike Tenay abs in the business.
Ooh, boy, you know, I learn something every day here. He's going to be taking on Rick Cornell, both graduates of the power plant. And Cornell, look at the look on that man's face. Not interested in the 24-second clock, a double dribble, or a technical. He just wants to beat somebody up. Great hair.
Let me tell you something about Cornell. The WCW Power Plant is adjacent to our office complex, right outside of Atlanta, Georgia. We get a chance now and then to go to the power plant, watch these kids work out. And Cornell is as tough as they come. Great conditioning. And these guys are really put to the ropes. I know, fans, you've probably seen it on 2020. There's been many features about the power plant. These guys are really put through a rigorous test every day. And I would venture to say guys with the power plant on a weekly basis sometimes put more ring time in than many of the major stars.
Oh, I don't disagree with that at all. Every time we go. Now, why has Jindrak still got the basketball? Oh!
Oh, you knew that was going to happen. Why did they let him bring it to the ring is what I want to know. Why didn't Billy Silverman say, get rid of it right now?
Maybe that was his idea. Going to keep it just long enough. Look at that. Fireman's carry roll through. Drop kick caught Jindrak in those highly developed abs. Arm drag takedown. Jindrak takes it outside. Going to take a 24-second timeout. Go.
For Rick Cornell, it wasn't a bad drop kick. He really didn't get up as high as he wanted to, but still, it got the effect that Cornell, it's again for guys from the power plant, it's a feeling out process. You go to the power plant, and they'll work out, they'll wrestle some guys and have some great matches, but there are no fans around. So it's a much different atmosphere for them to come out in an arena with a lot of fans in it and wrestle. It's a much different scenario for them, and that's why here on Saturday night, this is a very important match for both Jindrak and for Rick Cornell.
Who will be the next breakaway from the power plant now, Jindrak? A little psychological game with Cornell using a height to his... Oh, come on. Why would you want to... And oh! There you go. The last time you'll try that trick, Cornell. Ooh! Suplex over the top. Says press cradle. Nice tip up by Jindrak into a test of strength. Cornell wants no part of it. Just stiff kicks right in the chest. Double leg sweep. Down goes Jindrak. Lateral press. Cornell on top for the two count.
Scott, can you believe it? It's going to be our 10th Super Brawl coming up this year.
I believe it.
I can't believe 10 of those have gone by. And, of course, the home of Super Brawl over the past couple of years has been out west in the San Francisco Bay Area. This should be a good one.
Always a pleasure to get out to the Bay Area in Northern California, especially at Super Brawl time. Jindrak springboard Larry all the way across the ring. Great agility and leg strength displayed by Jindrak. Lateral press, Jindrak on top, Cornell on it too.
Two, a three. Well, now he's arguing with Billy Silverman. Kind of an odd move that time. He told Cornell to get up, and then he decided to put the lateral press on him. So a little bit of indecisiveness that time maybe cost Jindrak. There's a three-pointer. How about that?
That was even NBA distance. Jindrak still has the headband on. Now reverse chinlock on Rick Cornell.
Well, Jindrak comes in with a basketball, Screaming Norman and a football helmet sometimes. So, and we're going to see Screaming Norman, I guess, later on in this program, aren't we?
Can't wait. If he can come close to that entrance from Wednesday night with the showgirls there from Vegas. MGM Grand did a phenomenal job hosting WCW Thunder. Front face, no, blocked by Cornell. Reverse, into the suplex. But Cornell, that may have been all he had left. Double sledge, a series into the swallow of the back by Mark Jindrak. Monday night, WCW Nitro. Now, clue me in here.
Okay.
It's Wilkes Barre.
It's Wilkes-Barre.
Wilkes-Barre. Listen to Jimmy Barron on those road reports. Called it Wilkes-Barre.
Yeah, it's Wilkes-Barre. It's the Wilkes-Barre Scranton area of northeastern Pennsylvania. Got a lot of family up there. We look forward not only to being there in front of a great crowd, but we look forward to continuing the tournament to crown a new Cruiserweight champion. Plus, I got to imagine that Ric Flair may be there since we saw him on Wednesday on Thunder.
I certainly hope so. Great to see the Nature Boy back. And great to see him giving props to the new world champion, Sid Vicious. Talk about earning that title. I realize I may be going out of limb here, but I don't know that any world champion has ever worked as hard just to get the belt legitimately around his waist. I mean, he had to win match after match after match. Wait a minute, Cornell.
It was a good move by Cornell, but now he's really got to suck it up here and keep the pressure on. I don't know if he can. But, you know, talking about Sid Vicious, it was a very hard road for him. But don't think for a moment that Ric Flair's return means that he's going to stand by on the sideline and just cheer a guy like Sid Vicious. You know as well as I that Ric Flair's going to put his name in the hat to get a title shot regardless of who the champion is.
Maybe he's recruiting. Maybe he wants Sid to be like commissioner of softball there in North Carolina or something.
Maybe so.
To the gut, drop kick. One more time in the chest. That's twice Cornell has done that. I wonder if maybe that's a strategy. Drop kick in the head. No, take it in the chest. Take his breath away, but look at that. Load over. Front face. Oh! Neck breaker. Lateral press. Put the leg. It's over. Rick Cornell. That's a great victory.
That's a great victory. That's a great move. What acceleration on that, kind of like a spinning neck breaker that time on Jindrak. And look at the development, the body development of Rick Cornell. I think this is a star in the making and a young man we need to keep our eye on here.
Mark it down. February 20th. It's Super Brawl 2000. The finals of the Cruiserweight Tournament. Bam Bam Bigelow and Brian Knobbs in a hardcore showdown. The Mamalukes take on Flair and Crowbar. It all goes down at Super Brawl.
Well, I have no idea what that conversation was about, but look back there. Pacing in his locker room area, Jeff Jarrett, moments away from going in the ring against Sid Vicious. Got to think is an understatement. Well, here comes Mark Jindrak, and we heard what the boss told Jindrak earlier, that he had something in store for him tonight, and I guess we're going to find out what that is.
Ric Flair turning the tables on the commissioner, Mike Sanders. We've seen where the Thrillers have the advantage. They have the edge, not knowing which members are going to be in the ring in a certain match or a tag team match. Well, Flair said he's going to turn it around on the Thrillers and Jindrak.
But who is he facing? Oh!
Uh-oh.
Oh! It's Goldberg!
That's one way to turn it around, isn't it?
Log on to WCWgear.com to get your Goldberg jersey. And I'm sure that's where Jindrak would rather be right now. Logging on somewhere than to be in the ring against Goldberg.
I think I just see Jindrak get down on his hands and knees and start praying, God. Was it my imagination or did he just do that?
Was he
trying to do something else?
Took a good look at his face right there. And you may be right as they stand here at the Mid-South Coliseum to welcome in one of the true greats in all of sports entertainment. A man whose record is now at 33-0. And 176 seems a long way away. But for Goldberg, as the old cliche goes, you line him up and I'll knock him down. No one has been able to derail this monster.
Every match is of the utmost importance because not only is the streak on the line, but also the career of Goldberg. Lose and your history. Mark Jindrak tonight, if successful, and Sid Goldberg in a tag team match with his teacher, the Sarge, against the newly formed team of the Total Package, Lex Luger and Buck Bagwell.
The fact is, and we heard Flair reinforce it earlier, even in the tag match, the streak is on the line. Some people think that maybe going in with Sarge as his partner would be a detriment, but Goldberg does not think so, and many of us behind the scenes know that's not the case. Sarge may have spent his time training men to be superstars, but he has performed day in, day out in the ropes, between the ropes. He is one of the toughest men, pound for pound, and a man that Goldberg certainly trusts.
Luger and Bagwell cannot afford to be overconfident. And Sin, Goldberg just took Jindrak and tossed the 6'5", 265-pound Jindrak to the floor, comes back up, springboard, caught him in midair.
Jindrak.
That's amazing.
Oh, man.
Incredible that he will take a man that size and manhandling.
He's measuring him for the spear.
Jindrak tried a move that we've seen him do night after night after night, but this guy was ready for it, guys. Ow!
That is about that.
Prelude. To the end.
He speared him out of his boots is what he did.
It's all over but the crying now, guys.
Goldberg has dominated this one. just like he's dominated every other match in the strip. Can it be 34? No! Wresting!
Throw it down with the jackhammer!
The count is now 34-0! But for Goldberg, one of the biggest nights, one of the most important nights for him, comes out in 11 days at WCW since Sunday from the Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. With his friend, his mentor by his side, he'll face two of the toughest in all of WCW, Luger and Buff.
Think of this, the man that created Goldberg, Sarge, could be the man that ends his career.
That's right.
If Sarge comes out on the losing end, upcoming at Sin on January the 14th in that tag team match.
Another dominating performance by the monster himself, Goldberg. Who's got something to tell us? What's this about?
Yes.
Well, let's find out. Seems like a lot of people got things on their mind going into Sin, guys.
The clock is ticking. 11 days, boys. Luger, Bagwell, and Sin, after I beat both your asses, you can wipe both your damn names off WCW's roster.
Whoa.
Because you're both next!
How about that? He doesn't just want them as a team. He wants them individually coming up at Sin.
Wants to prove himself at Sin against Luger and Bagwell.
Let's not forget, Bob, later on in this telecast against the Sarge in a one-on-one matchup. Coming back with more. Stay with us.
All the news on the WCW Hotline.
On the eve of WCW's sold-out pay-per-view event, welcome back, everyone, to WCW Saturday Night. And check this out. Mark Jindrak from the power plant. I think he's having flashbacks to his days in college, Scott Hudson.
Well, we've heard the story about Jindrak. That's how he came to the power plant. Lifetime ban from the NCAA for rough conduct on the basketball court. So what better place for someone like that than pro wrestling? But why is he in his basketball trunks and bring the basketball with the headband? What is he? He gonna shoot free throws? What's up?
I'm not sure, but you're right. I guess that is a natural transition for someone that was banned by the NCAA. Come to World Championship Wrestling. See if you can prove yourself in WCW. And to date, from what I hear from Paul Orndorff, who's not only a member of the Old Age Outlaws, but also the boss of the WCW power plant, he tells me that there's been a little bit of friction and a little bit of heat between these two men, both graduates of the power plant in Atlanta, Georgia, as Alex Skipper has been given the basketball by Jindrak.
It's a straight pass, not a bounce pass. Whoa! A little distraction. Get that basketball out of there. Good kick, Nick. Jindrak taking advantage.
Now that's what the swerve was, and now we realize why Mark Jindrak brought the ball out with him to the ring.
My apologies to Billy Silverman. Obviously not Nick Patrick. They look a lot alike, though. Whoa!
They don't look anything alike. Besides the fact that they're wearing a black and white shirt.
That's all I need. Crossbar breaker from Alex Skipper on Jindrak. Jindrak waiting for the whistle.
You know, we've been really impressed with Elix Skipper on this broadcast in the past couple of weeks. Not only a good mat technician, but also not afraid to go to the top rope and use some high-flying, top rope, high-risk moves. Just pulled him down to the mat.
You know, earlier on, we saw Jeff Jarrett and exactly what Terry Funk did to him, bringing out the legends, George the Animal Steel, Tito Santana, and of course, Superfly Jimmy Snuka. And tomorrow night at sold out Triple Threat Theater, started off in the dungeon, a ropeless ring. How on earth are these two guys gonna have a match in a ropeless ring?
Well, one thing you have to think about when you go back to the dungeon days, that's where Chris Benoit trained.
Yeah.
Think of the famous dungeon in Calgary, Alberta, Canada. Stu Hart, the father of world's champion Bret the Hitman Hart, was so instrumental in not only training Benoit, but giving him among his first breaks in the wrestling business. So when you think of an advantage, or you think of a home turf, a match to be fought under dungeon rules as well, it's going to be a case there where you can beat a guy by pinfall, submission, or by moving him out of the ring. He's got to go all the way out to the floor. You can beat him that way as well. I have to give Benoit a huge advantage in the matchup under dungeon rules. But then when it comes to the bunkhouse brawl, well, I don't know. Jeff Jarrett's the master of that.
Jeff Jarrett grew up in that Memphis territory. The son of Jerry Jarrett. Jeff Jarrett has had a lot of bunkhouse brawls. I don't know how many Chris Benoit has had. I seriously doubt if he's ever really been in a real bunkhouse. We know Jeff Jarrett has. I agree. If I read you correctly, I think the edge in that one goes to Jeff Jarrett, which means it may be decided in the caged heat. And there, the advantage goes to the crippler. He's building the cage. He loves to launch that Air Canada from the top of an 18-foot-high steel cage. He may do it tomorrow night, and if he does, it will spell the end of Jeff Jarrett and his run as U.S. champion.
Now, think of how important positioning of each match on the card is. Because the United States Heavyweight Championship belt is on the line in every bout as Jindrak goes for the cover finally and barely gets a one count on Skipper and again a one count before Skipper kicks out. Because that U.S. belt is at stake in every match, whatever match is the final bout between those two individuals, whoever would have the advantage in that match is going to leave the pay-per-view with the title belt. For example, if the dungeon match is last, huge advantage for Benoit. But what if the bunkhouse brawl is the last of the three bouts? We've already seen Jarrett have success in the bunkhouse brawl back at Starrcade.
Against Dustin Rhodes, a man who knows his way around a bunkhouse.
So I think it really comes down to the order of those three matches, how they're fought at Sold Out.
Skipper on top. Using a momentum shift up top. Fell down into a pinning combination, but Jindrak, look at this. Well, that'll get you at least two personal fouls right there.
The other interesting thing about the title belt being on the line in every bout, you could win just one out of the three matches if it's the last of the three and still leave Sold Out as the U.S. champ.
Skipper into the corner. Jindrak charges in. Whoa! What a maneuver. Body press in the corner using the turnbuckle and his body to squeeze the breath out of Elix Skipper.
Well, Mark Jindrak is using the advantage that he has, and that's his size, height, and weight on Elix Skipper to control much of this matchup. Scoop and a big slam from Jindrak.
Into a rear chinlock now by the former NC2A basketball standout. I don't think he stood out. Yeah, he didn't stand out for all the right reasons either. Sure, the file on that guy in Kansas is about 4 or 5 inches thick with complete letters.
Yeah, that was just from his teammates.
Whoa, I believe it. Oh, Skipper. Great counter to the rear chinlock. And Jindrak may have loosened up a couple of lowers.
Double jawbreaker that time from Skipper. Drove him down one time and then hung on and connected on a second jawbreaker. Nice move to avoid the clothesline. Back kick caught him in the midsection.
You know, coming up in our next segment, we will take an exclusive look at the situation involving Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell. We will hear from Kimberly when Mean Gene Okerlund sat down with the beautiful former Nitro girl to get her side of this story. Skipper on top for a two count on Jindrak.
Well, it's about time. We've been hearing from Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell on and off for the past couple of weeks. We finally had that showdown with both men in the ring, so I guess it was only natural that we hear from Kimberly, get her side of the story.
The rumors running amok that Buff Bagwell... Oh! From shoulder high into a reverse neck breaker. Skipper is still down and Jindrak not covering it. Why is he wasting time here? What if the shot clock were running? Jindrak, springboard up top, no. Took too long with that maneuver. Skipper back up in the corner. Jindrak is down. He hit hard. Oh, look at the agility of Elix Skipper. Up top, Jindrak caught one right in the face. Drop kick, back press, hook the leg, and it's done. Elix Skipper is your winner. Wow.
Nice missile drop kick off the top by Elix Skipper. Mark Jindrak controlled much of this matchup, but he just didn't have the proper level of focus and concentration. And in the end, it was Elix Skipper who got the win.
It's the most prestigious belt in all of professional wrestling, the WCW World Heavyweight Championship.